Maybe you've heard of Microsoft Defender for SQL, but did you know there's also Microsoft Defender for cloud? And it has come such a long way. There's so many cool things to see, detect, analyze, and remediate all in one place. You're going to want to learn all about this and how it relates to CNAPP this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Ketilin. Ketilin, thanks so much for coming on Data Exposed. Welcome.
Thank you, Anna. It's great to be here.
It's great to have you here. And today, we're going to be talking about some security things related to Microsoft Defender for Cloud. We're going to get right into it because we have a jam-packed, demo-packed session. We're going to start by asking you, Ketilin, we've been hearing a lot about this thing called CNAPP. Can you tell us a little bit more about it and how Microsoft Defender for Cloud ties into it and how it relates to databases?
Okay, great. So Cloud Native Application Protection Platform, or CNAPP, is a unified platform that simplifies securing your cloud applications throughout their entire lifecycle, that is from code to runtime. It does that by combining the best of workload protection solutions, or threat protection solutions, and security posture management solutions. This allows you a one-stop shop to protect your entire application footprint, your cloud application footprint. So where do databases come in? Databases are a critical layer of your application stack, and they require all of these protection and security abilities, and not only the application, right? Because we all love databases and know how important they are. So Microsoft Defender for Cloud as one such CNAPP solution, includes top-tier database protection abilities for managed and hosted databases. And this is going to be our focus in this session. So we are super excited to share these new data security features that we've launched recently that allow you to A, identify sensitive or discover sensitive data in your managed databases, that is Azure SQL and even RDS databases in AWS, and also have a central view of your data estate as part of a data security dashboard that we are seeing just now. This data security dashboard combines the best of our Defender CSPM solution, which allows you, gives you contextual security abilities on top of your environment, together with workload protection plans such as Defender for SQL or Defender for Storage. The purpose of this dashboard is to allow you to understand where your data is, to map your data estate, to understand which data is at risk, either direct, indirect, immediate, or potential, and then also dive into the types of sensitive information that was discovered across your data estate and additional security context that the dashboard brings up. Now, let's go into Contoso's environment and see how all of this looks. Yeah. Okay, so as we go into the dashboard, we will see the overview section, and that tells us if we have to look at one thing, it's this section. Okay? It shows us what kind of data assets do we have, storage, managed databases, that's Azure SQLs, RDS, and all the other past databases, hosted databases, that is your SQL VMs, that is your Arc-enabled SQLs, and also a cool thing that MDC does is it identifies database software that's that runs on VMs and surfaces that as shadow databases inside of Defender for Cloud. So you will know to treat that VM as a database and not just any plain other VM. Now, below that, you can see the coverage. And in this case, we can see that all of our databases enjoy the maximum protection possible from the Defender plans. And then we get to the sensitive discovery results. And we see that we found 30 resources with sensitive data, we discovered them. And out of them, 22 require attention. And this number, it shows a big red note here. Yeah. This is what you'd want to look at and try to minimize when you work with the dashboard. Okay, so how? And that's where the next section of the dashboard comes into play. So it breaks down this number and into two. We have the active threat to sensitive data, and we can see that there are two resources with sensitive data that are at risk from active alerts, and in them we found credit cards or US social security numbers. By clicking on this link, we will get to the security alert page, which is filtered for those sensitive resources. And here we already see that Ninja SQL has an ongoing suspected brute force attack. And what we see here is just alerts coming from our beloved Defender for SQL that we all already know and love, that supports our SQL estate across PaaS services and SQL VMs and on-premise VMs. So when we click on this alert, we can see all the additional context about this alert and remediation actions we can take. Okay, so we took care of the immediate threats, and then we can we should look at the potential threats. The potential threats are covered through surfacing attack paths on resources with sensitive data. What is an attack path, you ask? So an attack path is a chain of misconfigurations that an attacker could leverage in order to get access to your data or your compute. If you remediate the misconfiguration in one link in that chain, you will break the attack path and block that kind of attack.
Wow, that's so cool. Yeah.
It is, and wait until you see that. So here, we can see an example of a direct threat to the database. Because it's kind of straightforward. We have a Azure SQL VM that's exposed to any public IP over the public internet. Yeah, I don't know how advised that is. And it also allows basic authentication. So if you use common usernames with weak passwords, potentially you could brute force that SQL server and then gain access to that very vulnerable, very valuable sensitive data that we discovered in the CRM database. Okay, and then you say, okay, so you're showing me stuff, what should I do? And this is where the remediation part kicks in. We show you the recommendations you need to break this this attack path, and in this case, you can choose either one of them, block public network access, it will eliminate this specific attack path. Okay, so let's take a look at something more complex. So here, it's slightly more complex. Okay, so here we have an attack path that describes a lateral movement attack. That means that an attacker, can you see this? Okay. That an attacker could leverage these weaknesses that we found on this MDC demo W2019 VM. Okay, it has vulnerabilities that indicate remote code execution. Okay, and then the attacker could leverage the internet access it has to this VM, take advantage of these vulnerabilities, then gain access to the managed identity assigned to that VM, and then, oh, look, what happens? It has permissions on our beloved CRM. Okay, and again, the attacker gained access to our database, which even if we secured properly from the public network, would still the attacker would still get access to the data.
Yeah, this is super cool because I think of like a data lineage view, but instead of a data lineage, this is like a threat lineage. Super cool, and super cool how it also shows you not just the path, but also the remediation.
Yeah, thank you. And I like the name. And by the way, this is just the beginning. We are now introducing automatic attack path generation that can just go on for a large number of nodes. And we even support multi-cloud attack path. So an attack path that can start on a vulnerable GCP compute VM. And then go to a VM in AWS and end up on an RDS database. This is totally something that we can surface in the system as well. So after going into the threats that that are responsible for this number, we also surface a number of data queries that show additional security context that may be relevant to your environment. A very cool scenario here is data resources accessible with plain text secrets. So Microsoft Defender for Cloud scans your VMs for vulnerabilities, but also looks for secrets on the VM. And in this case, we can see that that we found a secret that is a connection string in this scenario that points to our CRM database. This database is has a lot of weaknesses in this environment. So this connection string points to the CRM database, and we can see that so we have a plain text credentials pointing to it from the Contoso DSVM machine. Mm. And look where that connection string comes from. It's a Jupyter notebook used for ML projects. So wow. Not something that we don't know from from real life, right?
Yeah. So and that, is this all part of the... the same dashboard?
So what was that? That's a good distinction because this is the Cloud Security Explorer, which is available as part of Defender CSPM, and it allows you to query the security map on your own. So we build queries that point to this, but once you're in here, you can totally edit the query and change it to your needs and liking, and there is a lot you can do here. So I really suggest you play around with it.
Awesome.
Yeah. And then we get to the last part of the dashboard, which gives us a deep dive look at the distribution of sensitive data, of the discovered sensitive data in our resources. So you can look at the distribution according to the information types that we detected, sensitivity labels, or the resources. And maybe this would be a good time to say a few words about sensitive data discovery and how it works. So this is a feature enabled as part of Defender CSPM. You turn on sensitive data discovery, your database, either RDS or Azure SQL databases will be assigned with a scanning date throughout the week, and we will scan it every week for sensitive data. The scan is lightweight, and it also doesn't send out any user data outside of the scanning environment. Right? So the only thing that that we report after discovery is what kind of information type we found and on which database, table, and column we found it. And we also have a huge set of information types that we can look for and a set of default ones that we search for. And if you want, you can also choose what to remove or add to this list.
Got it. And I think, you know, a lot of people would use these for sure, but also like some folks define their own custom kind of regexes for that they might want to be displayed or scanned for. Is that something that would show up here, and does it apply if it's just in Azure or even outside Azure?
So as part of the Microsoft ecosystem, we know to integrate with labels with automatic labeling rules or custom information types that were defined in Microsoft Purview. So we'll know to use these same configurations across all the resources that Defender for Cloud supports and multi-cloud environments. Talking in the same taxonomy that the entire Microsoft ecosystem knows to use as well.
Awesome. Cool.
Yeah. And just wanted to show, once we do look at the sensitive data, we have all the context on what we found and where. And we can also export the data to CSV, so we can either process it offline if there are a lot of findings, or send it to the data owner to review later. And we also show you, that was sensitive data discovery, we also show you the distribution of internet exposed resources. There are some resources with where it makes more sense than on others, right? And that is the data security dashboard in a real quick review. I'd love for everyone to try this out and let us know what you thought.
Yeah, absolutely. Catalin, thanks so much for showing us this. Like, this is next level. Like, I've seen Microsoft Defender for SQL a couple years ago, and now to see how far it's come and how expansive it's become is just really cool. So thanks so much for coming on the show. To our viewers, go ahead and like this episode, leave us a comment, and let us know what you think. We'll put some links in the description for you to go learn more. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.